شب عاش وحلا دين حك كربا جيا كيا تيار بقسكير.
My hometown, a city of Nazran, Republic of Ingushetia, Russian Federation. It's the youngest republic and it has the highest birth rate in the country. The name of Ingushetia derives from the village of Angusht, where in 1770 representatives of a few Ingush families signed a treaty with Russia, by which they entered the empire in exchange for peace and protection. These images have become our public face, a North Caucasian trademark. They no longer make a national TV headlines. And for people who live in Ingushetia, it's not a string of shocking incidents, but sad scenes of daily life. There is not a single family that has not been affected, including mine. How did it come to this? What's happening? Are we becoming the new Chechnya? In looking for answers, you'd want to unravel the history. But Ingushetia has no official scientifically written history. Our past is mostly sketched in legends, myths, and memories of the older generation. If Russia is a riddle wrapped in mystery, then Ingushetia has been wrapped inside Russia for more than 200 years. But I wanted to find out more, and for that I had to go to the very heart of my nation. What is the purpose of your visit to the border zone? Said a modulated voice behind a black bulletproof glass when I applied for a permit to enter the zone. The zone lies to the south of Nazran, in the central part of the Caucasian mountain range. It is a 30-kilometer FSB-controlled buffer between Russia and Georgia, but to us, it's the heart of our nation. To request a permission to enter from FSB, former KGB, it's an obligatory procedure now.
عايشت من طول ديك خني دين
خني أقول ما شيء خاي
يا هاي مغيار
ما شيء خاي
هذا واحد دين يا أسرع
مشاية
حال إسرع بقول مشاية شو
ما إنه يا أخ حلوش
Ingushetia is the smallest North Caucasian republic with a population of nearly 500,000. Sandwiched between Chechnya and North Ossetia, it has an international border with Georgia. The republic was formed in 1992 when Chechnya announced its bet for independence and the Soviet Autonomous Republic of Chechnya-Ingushetia was split. Yet the history of its people has ancient roots in the Caucasian mountains.
خودتی لات ترلر دادوخ تو استر دلگ یاد تو چیون هاشی هات یاد تو توش گیر دالو لیتی توش یعنی استن داتیش Olamaz. Yeriz hozul dekel al işi açı muhti diyer. Hozul dekel düz diyer dat oz.
Dey be hamok, dey be hamok.
Dey muhk, bu dey muhk dağ yeç işi aç, şeyin mogus. Dey muhk, lor o biyes hacı biyes. Muhti can lilu yiyiz, vah muhti dikhal yiyiz, nağ eh ezdel lilu diyes. Eh ezdel duatsa guahır vats.
Alihan, my host, and his friend Muharbik. A custom obliges them not to question a guest about anything for the first 3 days. And that's a part of Eh Ezdel, our centuries-old code of moral behavior. Together with these mountains, they constitute the most important ingredients of our national identity. We were robbed of one of them in 1944.
Дух халхан дадяны чок. Чон чам хо болуш. Анал ду цуалсу. Халхы галгай огдын ети кымляр чи эггерте бар чи кымо бусыл да хат ица галгай олай кымды. Аз бусыл да хат ицлех аз дарги да чи бяши хал. Так дух диали болуш. Соған дұқынып, лил бәр. Бағдар әлчі язычество олі, классический язычество қане цығылғы ер. Ған әлчі кертер диалхану, соған диалы өзі әлгіцеш өттеш қаны замақ бұа, лұғақ барыж. Үшқы диалі олыш қанда цынақ царих. Елгісіш өтдеш қан, ца дұғы жмор, ца хамаш қан иқыш. Аз мәт ламты дақ мәт селі яқыр, ца елгіс. Ханз долы жды іс. Қоқ дияға түсуд. Ши қалын яқы елгіс қан, үш дуатсы жды. Дақ ца ханз барчылаты жды цари. Ца елгіс, үз елгіс долчы нақты болыш, түсуд.
Mountains occupied the central part in English mythology. They were homes to the gods of my predecessors and our epic heroes. Here I found out that many pagan festivals were celebrated until the beginning of the 20th century. Led by a priest, people would go up the Metlom, taking with them triangular breads and sacrificial bull calves, whose horns were tied with a white ribbon, like the ribbon on the priest's staff. And Tselom, the holy mountain. Frequently hidden by clouds, it was the home to a god thunderer, Tsela. Every year, women went up to Tselom to celebrate supreme god Dala. And at the very summit, they danced around stones erected by an English epic hero, Kaloi. Did you hear how he cried Alleluia? It's an echo of forgotten religion that once came to these parts. Habayirdi. It is usually translated as the Church of 2000 Holy Men. This is one of the most ancient examples of Christian architecture on the territory of Russian Federation and dates between 8th to 10th century. Its role varied throughout time from a church to an assembly of the noblest representatives of different clans. And in my days, in 2001, It was in the center of army maneuvers during the Second Chechen War. These gorges served as pathways for many armies. When walking here for the first time, I wondered if this is the same gorge through which in the 14th century Tamerlan moved to meet his greatest rival, the Golden Horde.
Eger halk az buaqt omxana Mongol zalgay tehish bian chichan ishi isha magas yoxiya yerik ari yitita san qarts baxa tehish bian chichan xetir gaha yuq metir motik iskhani tik khishab naqa eger halk taq mal zanr yol qojmo dai hay baxap zgulo xali baxap arm khitsa abdaq kap tirkul dehib banib Эш койортхани хамхий тергими якали шкертир та юрту алышканда цар цар ялмыш якал якал кал город мийс сигер да булбам калаж эгер хал хакетер га циги булбан кыл беш бу сигер арияник культур хама
These people aren't building contractors. They are fathers and sons, restoring their legacy, a medieval residential tower. Every stone has its place. This rule of harmony creates a very strong structure. These towers mostly date between 12th to 17th centuries, but some are presumed to be as early as 6th century. The ground floor was reserved for cattle. People occupied the first floor, and the last floor was reserved for guests. A strict hospitality custom demanded that a room was always kept ready for a visitor. Despite the fact that a few families, members of one clan, frequently shared the tower. I wonder how many families could live like that nowadays. Our society is a system of family clans. Every clan has its tower, or at least knows where it was. Even now, in the 21st century, we continue living in the complex mechanism of unwritten rules, customs and moral codes. To an outsider, they might seem chaotic and archaic, but in reality, they play an important part in achieving stability and harmony. These laws had been created with the same thorough thought and precision as the towers themselves.
Ugala dok ye kurish hadi lat shi bram un chana hashiya hadi amdi wadirish kuna shi hayni lo ji ham ta shi otti ti shi dala ush haq ush isidi chas chada malar chan hashlu ji ham shi us kurish ko ayulish sraz shi hayish ta shi ma tiish shi chi hayi ta de si da ush ayq tiish shi hayi ta sraz shi ush kul ko ayqish tsul da tsul tsa ham do hadi da wadirish رحم الله على حي جورجي حم شو حي شخنة وجي حكي شيء كيتش ما خم بار قير حائز ديش خم مولا غوري ولا سك حبيان ولا از غور دقيق شخني تقيرة قيو حم ده شيء ما ده حم أحد يجي قيرة قير سواشي يك شخني
These towers stand out from the rest. They are military towers, Vov, built to protect a clan during local feuds and foreign invasions. They were positioned in zigzag to alert neighbors in case of an attack. Vovnushk is one of the youngest and largest tower complexes built on the territory of Ingushetia. Look how it cuts into its native cliff. My predecessors were no nomads. They rooted into these mountains like the fortress. Multiple arched ceilings were built inside of the towers to protect against earthquakes. Military towers reached up to 30 meters in height and generally comprised of 5 or 6 levels, with higher levels reserved for family and their defenders, and the lowest for captured prisoners. Corner passes between floors were very narrow, so people had to stay slim and fit all the time. The entrance was on the second level, and a ladder would be lifted in from the outside, creating an impregnable fortress. The stone at the very top of the roof ensured that the whole structure remained strong. It was so highly prized that a builder received a horse just for placing the stone. To ensure that the tower could withstand blows, a very strong solution was devised, and master builders guarded its secret. The local legend has it that when the towers were blown up, some of them took off and landed right back intact. In the last millennium, the Ingush nation has been on the border of near extinction many times. The devastating Caucasian War, also known as the Russian conquest of the Caucasus, which lasted for nearly half a century until 1864, left lingering memories of carnage and fear. A part of fertile lands occupied by Ingush farmers were reassigned to Cossacks, deployed to guard the new frontier. It was the lack of land that originally forced the highlanders to move back to lowlands and ask for Tsar's protection. But a century later, hunger and injustice were what they had got instead. I don't find it surprising that when the Socialist Revolution of 1917 came, the majority of the Ingush people supported it. But I find it hard to understand what followed after. This is a house of Gapur Akhriyev, a prominent Ingush revolutionary. It stands overlooking River Terek. On the other side is North Ossetia. Here is Gapur. He took an active part in fighting for Bolsheviks' cause in the Caucasus. He died age 30, just after becoming a head of Ingush Revolutionary Committee. This is a list of other Ingush revolutionaries, just one of many squadrons. promised idea of social equality was very close to Highlanders' mentality. And the last Russian imperial map of the North Caucasus, a short-lived unity known as Terская Oblast. After many transformations, when the Bolsheviks finally secured a foothold here, it broke into autonomous regions. North Ossetia and Ingushetia were the last nations to be parted, but they still shared capital city Vladikavkaz, a former Russian fortress built in the place of Ingush village, Zaur Kov. But the Ingush effort in the revolution was soon forgotten, just like the street lamps around the revolutionary's house. Installed to celebrate Moscow Olympic Games in 1980, they never worked. In 1933, Vladikavkaz was given to North Ossetia. And in the following year, Ingushetia was merged with Chechnya, with its capital in Grozny, losing in economy, education and culture. Have you ever seen an avalanche in the mountains? It can be triggered by a small external stress on the snowpack, but soon it turns into a devastating force. The reassignment of Vladikavkaz was just the beginning of many devastating events that followed. Twelve years ago, my host Alihan came to settle in his family tower. On his arrival, a young border guard ordered him not to cross into the border zone, or he'll be shot. Go ahead, said Alihan.
No, so you walk very damn well, bumbat, back and back, it's a dead, this little. For this today, that is hostra. No, hazard them did for this today, yea, hold let the third del hazard did for. Trust more had it do walk, Lonnie, a darriet is yet, yet a rich as a at Digler, a rat, Marriott, and you a dead Marriott, and here, Lonnie, a damariet, sir. Gora bagat destiakatsa apasnaya latsa apasnaya alazamu dest bagyalu yeshin mogushan.
Hold while you can. For every Ingush born before the 1944, these words have a special meaning. For centuries, these mountains protected us. This is where our clan towers stand, and where the bones of our predecessors lay undisturbed in the sun graves. Even though Islam's strict rules demand for bodies to be buried in the ground, They remain untouched out of respect for the beliefs our predecessors once had.
ما كشي حدوث كان شي غالي يوتر سن استريني غال مو يشر خد تمايات يكور دوتش شي غالي جمو حد شي حد وجي زراني كيش تاع وقت خنطس انا اشتاق بالش شي قچا واحد فيش شي خيط نياتش تاع هو غواش نيزبيرن حمديس جما كاش مجد ما كاش مش فتن يالشي شي تعور حلق دوق لزرقيت وقيت شي سموغش خلش قچان شي لزه ده حت داريت داچو اتچ اوج خنوس شي داچو اتچ ترخيت قيق سق اوج خلچ سديان ون از الوخي ويقي الوخي ولي شي كوم ات اوج خنوس اق چوغان شي داچو ود چخان شي ديوس خني اوجو پيريلي كات بولي اش حماش خنيت شدوق حدوث شوخ صغان داش حش شوش بيوغل يوخر ياخش چامي بالي توپر كات بالي تتاش وغاز شين دين قادين شي چيچ يوخش خان شين قواش محوش خان بوخ صداش قواش حميلي شين دار جز وخوش خان صداش دا از داش حش تخون او بيوغل يوخش دار تخسي بلا تبع كاش خان سهم يارس چيخش
Лами дахэти ари нарда дэшу.
Шибо тава ханар дэстэнт эсунди гэдэгэду.
Айрин дэр эс. Айрин нара хамти ха тхадиша тхайса дадар сэцэ. Хамти ха тхада ар вяхар.
Шали нар гуачхана. Тхадар зада асир, тхайурт да асир.
Сэдэдду ах, нанам чи.
سالتی این بری ماست نگیرد.
چقدر اوریت تا بیگل مو برسه بر. تو داریش قطع ماره دهاتر. تا دهگودی تا سهگودی شپل میت لاتر تو عوتیه.
تخدا دویگر نارگ بیخ کایرین. لا سیل سویت حاول یخ ان.
سن نگاس خین و اولی دا و حبوگر سگ حبوگا و مال دیات سگ سان ابیدر.
با پرکاز ستالین ویسل کی یوشون تاهم. شش ساعت خماری آشش، سپرتولیلی یه چه آروجی پرنمات دادشون.
اگر شن ساعت فوکیش داد در واه.
چیکه چه دهر سهر نان خوال خوش از وارتا بند کرد دخ. ایت مگزه هم لک هفارچیه حقولیه.
تا حجت در دانش دی بر تیجت در نیش کاش فرم آتی. ساد عجلا هم حیتیش و ازش تیت دول در برز تسی دویتش بیش عاردی ها نیش کاش دوخت در تو.
ماشین تو دیت در تو. تو دیت تا زنگ ور واق ور.
برو آشید گه. سوتیلی اشی وگون شد اش دیگر تو دیون
سپایش داشت دیگر اوجش فیش دال آخوند گون اشی اگر محبر گون اشی اگر درد در
از ری ایس بای شوزگی دیلاشار تا قلا شور البته میکردی هر تا
خمیریس چه هم زیانه حدا ادواس جتون دی حد دو ادواس دوش دچی خلا در کن دو ادواس شو
سانسی بس لانه آج خلط قطع دو آج خارن سیگ بیغاش نسی لینی دی هسی شکر چیه تر تون تیح تو بگ دو آج وطر دیش شکر چیه تر تو نیغ ار دی آج
خوش متک واسه توش با قبرش آخرش کج مل بر اش اورد عتش دی هن تدارت خواه
دوغش کان سموگر نخ مبری دو حیسا اش تو وشت ون سد داغی تتر صبرش ون اولی توش
ون ره تر حین ر دار خواست
دوگ داشت ایار سبره، ولی زس نوشای ول نه به ایار، استالی نخوش خود داشت ایار ایار وای لیدو ایار و ربوت نیست، استال نخوری و ایار دو خود داشت ایار.
On the 23rd of February 1944, for alleged collaboration with Hitler, the entire population of Ingushetia was deported to Kazakhstan. Old and young, everyone. Ironically, the Ingush men who fought in the Red Army against the Nazis also shared the fate of their nation. Our homeland was split between Russia, Georgia and North Ossetia. And we became a phantom nation, crossed out from history books, encyclopedias and archives.
Kazakhstan is a country that has خوبخوشوار شیعه شیر
متصل خلمیش آه دیالیش در نه دیالیش در متصل دیه من
سه حد اجبار دست داری لب وادر توی هست کردش دیست هست تو طی این در بین هست ون خواهد باقی نه دوک نه بیک
آخر و مس نیگ مقایسی ودز ده هم داتر
حد اتصالش مال اتصالش تدو مرد اتصالش بعدی و موتیک اتصالش بیاد برد عدد موتیک تغالش، ساپ تغالش نه اپیدمی خلر.
سه دادم کاشی یه تیفا سبکش خلر، تایش لذرا. سونا خدیا وشی ولر، دا ولر، دانه یلر، شک وشی ولر، یشی یلر.
دگاش اتبیش من دو خامل بود، مسل ولر دگاش اتبیش مکبر نه.
اون سعی آنیکه داول ایشواتش لر. مرزله تایر، پالترا متر آچیودرش، دگرسا، کشدو آخر، از سه آخ متر سوی آچ، اشت آچ بیاکر توش.
ازم هد دی دی تا وقت باسر، یک یه در مارده.
دال، بسمن دال، دم خواهش میاد، استخوان تخش میده، کرسن دال دم خواهش میاد، از دال، از دال تی بیشتر. از دال اردی اردیس. قدم على زبال ياقص سام قدم على بلدك ذات شو صدى الجاب دير تخيهاش تبيش لك برس صدى الجاب دير لي لقوار سيوار
بيدي سياد سيدمون قدو ناخا تصباق بقو يلر نو تصباق بقو يلر نتو دا كودا اني خطيات تا تريتوري где мы ранее проживали, его передали состав Северной Осетии, руководство было осетинское, поэтому нам не давали возможность Петря прописаться и жить, и работать, и так далее.
Stalin left a time bomb by reassigning the western part of Ingushetia to North Ossetia, where 40% of the Ingush population lived prior to the deportation. Even the former village of Angusht was given away and renamed as Tarska. By the latest estimates, a half of the population died, but the majority of survivors hurried back home. Only in the 1960s did the population reach the same level as prior to the deportation. Many rare books, collections of folklore texts, and archives were destroyed. Graveyards were leveled with the ground and gravestones used as building material. A number of medieval memorials and towers were blown up. Archaeological discoveries in the region could not be attributed to the Ingush nation, as it did not officially exist. Although in 1957 we returned into history, we could not return our history. Truly a phantom nation.
هاتون خوخده دوت يتش دوخ ده دوت الله يحمش تام بقدر إلتش أصنوعي وهي إستوري كذيك عمليات وين مغاس يخا مغاس يخ يخا دخات خيرة هم خات سنر تختل دخو خوش در ميتت ميتو هايوخ ميتو يوخ خيتي بچا حلقي شمير اورارتو سيك هنزت يها سرموت سايو تابليچكا اشتر دغلغي ميتت قيت بي ايش يول جيت اخ از بوزم خندل خو تا يا اوغزر دابا خابوش كوفكازير يتيجر شميرير اورارتور اوس حبيخ حبيخ كاب از وين قيت دي خلد از غلغي مل بیاخاب مل بیاخاب اتصال تصل حلقر دردی منگولش اوز باخلی خانچ استوریخ دوخم دسا دوخم دات گرگریش حابو او استربونو امازون کاش جی هانس تیها دوخو مل بولچ دیشا نو دیشا چناخ اوچونش داچویا کافکازی لومش خندلگی داچویا گرگریش خندلگی اوز امازون کاش خنلگی داچ آدن تو سوژه.
Амазонки Кавказа, судя по обычаям и обрядам, которые сохранились по сей день в Ингушетии, это не вымысел. Один из таких обрядов – это праздник, который женщины праздновали до 19 века, праздник, о котором даже рассказывала моя бабушка, когда женщины один раз в год на один день оставляли всю семью, все неотложные дела и уходили в безлюдное место. В этой местности они выбирали среди старейшин самую мудрую женщину, она была у них царицей. И самых красивых девушек одевали как охрану, и они были воины этой царицы. И другие женщины, наряженные в мужские одеяния, вооруженные, занимались далеко не женскими делами. То есть они устраивали скачки, стрельбу, состязались в стрельбе, вернее, вот, боролись, джигитовали, танцевали. И ни один мужчина не смел подойти близко к этой местности. Вот. Этот праздник назывался Сесерице.
The folklore of Ingushetia preserved many tales about beautiful women with golden hair who lived in local forests and were hostile to men. Now the forests of Ingushetia are full of very real hostility, counter-terrorist operations, so their secrets and treasures remain undiscovered. On the border with Chechnya stands a giant fortified gate with tall towers. The wall stretches across the river gorge from rock to rock, guarding an entry from the east. The last time an archaeological expedition surveyed the site was in the year 2000, but the gate's secret remains undiscovered. The surrounding forest is now covered in landmines. In these mountains, in every step, you come face to face with ancient history. And yet, you feel so disappointed, unable to piece it together or share it. And it feels that more of our land is slipping out from our hands and becoming one big fighting field for a game we know nothing of. When Ali Khan settled in his family tower, he was the only person living here for miles. With no electricity, gas or running water supplies, he started restoring this medieval village and gave a start to a new community.
Here, Jilui Gali, Bah, Nah, Bah, Jogalir. That's a Hatoya, Dio Hatchelte Hatoya. Ucha Eswan, that's on. Here, Gale, Jilui Gali, Bash, the Atcher. Nah, Bah, Jogalir. Hatoya, has that a hashback is more barishulus. Aishul, Salaishulus. Show how this, show salah.
ماشي بيحك الساقيت قواه تخش دينا خوز غمال دو دا يخو دا خوز شي هما مالي تخش داغ داغي سانشن ساتا داغي
شي بل
دا جا حتش دوخ تخلو الخو وطسا إسرا بلاد اوز واخش في خزاكيك ازم نرمال لول تخشي وقي اوز دي او اقيت
To me, every Ingush born before the deportation of 1944 is a survivor. Here in the mountains, together with their bread, they shared with me the stories of their ordeal, and yet none of them was bitter or carried hatred in their hearts. They know the wisdom of centuries that bitterness does not help to go on living and making the most out of it. Alihan Muharbik, their neighbor Israpel and his wife, believe that by living in the place of their ancestors, they will somehow retain the control of this land, despite of any imposed security restrictions and threats. This trip has taught me that the heart of the Ingush nation is in the mountains. And as long as at least one Ingush will continue living here, this heart will go on beating. Returning to the lowlands was like a crushing experience for me. And despite the fact that everything is so new here, it doesn't seem to encourage. Ingush people came into the 20th century with no idea of statehood. And by the end of it, we've got our own autonomous republic, but its borders are still undefined. Magas is a newly founded capital of Ingushetia. It bears the name of an ancient town, Maaz, a capital of a medieval kingdom of Alania, which existed in the Greater Caucasus until its destruction in the 13th century. Since the collapse of the Soviet Union, Ingushetia was busy rebuilding itself as a nation inside Russian Federation. And as any nation, it needs a historical past. When Yeltsin came to power and many archives were declassified, there was a window of opportunity to find out more about our national history. But the years of ideologically driven history science left a confusing and unreliable legacy. Museum collections created in the Ingush Cultural Research Center in Vladikavkaz in 1926 ended up in a small regional national history museum in Nazrin. Part of them were lost in the years of the deportation. Another part was destroyed in Grozny during the Chechen War. North from Nazrin, on the bank of River Sunja, stands Mausoleum Borga Kash. A head of archaeological research center told me that this is a unique Islamic memorial in the North Caucasus and one of the oldest on the territory of Russian Federation. A lot of mystery and conflicting theories surround the memorial to this day. Different sources report a discovery of a few human mummies in coffins and also skeletons of a dog and a rabbit. The memorial dates from the early 15th century, and the Arabic writing at the entrance translates as Bek Sultan, the son of Hudaynad. In the last two centuries that the memorial has been studied, not much came to light regarding the identity of the buried. On the contrary, the remains of those bodies have mysteriously disappeared. The story of Borga Kash is just one of many. The government's initiative to revive tourism industry has been run aground by FSB-enforced restrictions on access to the historical mountainous area in the border zone. For locals, it's hard to get to, but for visitors, It's nearly impossible, especially now that the situation in the Republic is threatening to explode. So the souvenirs remain unrequested. In this state of uncertainty, almost all the industry has been halted, and even the local oil producer operates in deficit. It was oil and gas that drove Hitler's army here in 1942. Mozdok-Malgabek operation was the last defense line on the way to the large oil fields of the Caucasus. In the north of Ingushetia, near the town of Malgabek, the Nazi army was stopped. The heroism of the Ingush soldiers who fought in the Red Army during the Second World War was concealed until the 1980s. And only then these commemoration memorials were built as a late rehabilitation attempt, just before the collapse of the Soviet Union. For years, we were not allowed to talk about our past. First, we became a phantom nation, and then our modern history became a phantom itself. And today, there is another phantom. Disappearing young men. According to a local human rights organization, approximately 180 men were kidnapped on the territory of Ingushetia between 2003 and 2010. It became extremely dangerous for young men to move freely in their own republic for a fear of being mistaken for a terrorist and shot on the spot or disappearing without a trace. This is my cousin Bashir, who worked as a mathematics and physics teacher in a secondary school. In 2003, he was kidnapped on his doorstep by men in black masks and camouflage uniform. We still don't know what happened to him. This is my other cousin, Rashid. He was the senior assistant to the public prosecutor of Republic of Ingushetia on supervision of FSB and national relations. On the 11th of March 2004, his car was chased and blocked by three vehicles. Again, men in masks and camouflage uniform. They pulled him out of his car. His whereabouts are unknown.
Что сегодня нам Гафура освободили. Мы говорим, обвинительный акт предъявите нам. Мы готовы вместе с вами просить наказание для него. Мы не обидимся. Ведь есть Конституция, есть суд, есть структура, есть власть. Обвините Гафура, если он виноват. Если он не виноват, ради всемогущего Аллаха, откликнитесь. Это не наша одна беда. Послушайте меня внимательно. Великий немецкий философ сказал, когда убивали евреев, я молчал. Когда убивали коммунистов, я молчал. Сегодня убивают меня, молчат другие. Да, когда пропадали дети в других семьях, Нам было жалко, мы на мазе за них молились. Но пока беда не постучалась в нашу дверь, мы не поняли, насколько сильна эта боль. Поймите, люди, ведь пропадают мальчики, которые должны воспроизводить наследство, от которых должны рождаться парни. Откуда они появятся, если будут умирать 22-летние парни? Кто нам за это ответит? Пожалуйста, не будьте равнодушны к чужой беде. Эта беда может прийти и к вам.
This memorial to the victims of political repressions was opened on the 23rd of February 1997. On the 53rd anniversary of the day when the Ingush nation was deported. Over half a century has passed, but the questions of our national losses remain unresolved. In 1991, Yeltsin signed the Repressed Nations Rehabilitation Act, which stated that our land, which we have lost during the deportation, was to be returned by the end of 1992. Instead, in the autumn of the same year, the Ingush living in the disputed area were expelled. Many were killed, old and young. Houses were burned.
Откуда вы идете?
Старский. Мы из Старского, но идем с Гули.
Нет, а вот вы идете из Старского, а как вы прошли сюда?
Мы до Гули добрались через горы.
Это ваш ребенок?
Да. У меня была двойня, второго нет.
А что с ним случилось со вторым?
This grieving mother is a refugee from Tarskaya, our former village of Angusht, where just over 200 years ago, the Ingush chose to enter the Russian Empire. She is just one of thousands who lost their homes and dear ones in 1992. My host in the mountains, Alihan, is one of those refugees. He managed to build a new home, but many others continue living in camps to this day, denied their rights to return. The Yeltsin's Rehabilitation Act is still in power, but people are losing their trust in laws and authorities. So the Stalin's bomb is still ticking. Not just here, but in many other parts of the Caucasus, making it one big gunpowder pile, ready to blow up, as violence only breeds more violence. What will become of our land? Will we hold it? Or will it be just a legend for our next generation? And what will become of that generation?
Sugana is going to come. I went to the house. I saw 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 the